is New York Tonight.
The fire department is set to launch a pilot program to cut down on which units respond to non-fire emergencies with lights and sirens. It's an effort to prevent accidents and reduce noise. But the Firefighters Union says it's a recipe for disaster. Our Amanda Farinacci has the story.
Lights and sirens, the sights and sounds of an emergency. But starting next week, the fire department is set to reduce the number of fire units that respond to certain types of emergencies with lights flashing and sirens blaring. A three-month pilot program known as Modified Response will be tested at fire companies all over Queens.
The history of the department's response with lights and sirens is that firefighters are responding to a serious emergency. Until somebody actually gets there, it is difficult to determine the extent of that emergency.
But the fire department says not all emergencies require the same response. And that's why it's testing to see the impact of reducing the use of lights and sirens for the second and third engine companies heading to emergency calls that are not fires, like a gas leak or a stuck elevator. The first responding unit will still respond with lights and sirens, but those that follow will do so at a reduced speed. The FDNY believes the program will lead to fewer accidents and less noise. But the Firefighters Union says the plan is confusing and could lead to more accidents, not fewer.
Now you have to make a decision whether or not this, in fact, is in the category where you, your company, normally would respond lights and sirens, but on this particular occasion you don't. And there's confusion, and that confusion is going to lead to maybe more accidents between fire apparatus.
John Jay College fire science professor Glenn Corbett says it's a delicate balance when it comes to making any changes to the way fire units respond to emergencies.
Some of these responses actually could turn out to be real emergencies, and so the city needs to be very careful.
The fire department says units are in constant contact with one another, and if an emergency develops, the second and third unit will be alerted. The FDNY also says the number of units responding to these emergencies will not change. The agency points out that last year alone, there were more than 50 accidents involving second and third due units, and that's exactly what it's trying to reduce. Amanda Farinacci, New York 1.